Here we go again. Kmart Haul part 569. I have another Kmart haul. I think since starting this series on my channel, my Kmart addiction has just gotten like 10 times worse. And honestly, I'm not even mad about it. So over the past few weeks since my last Kmart haul, I have obviously treated myself on the days where I don't feel 100% to a cheeky little Kmart trip, which I don't think is the healthiest thing, but if it's what makes me feel better, I don't even care. So in today's video, I have my most recent Kmart finds to share with you. I'm very excited because I am now not only looking at the home decor section, I'm also looking in the office section, in the book section. I'm fully diving in to the entirety of Kmart. So if you do like Kmart hauls, then definitely make sure that you hit subscribe, because as you can tell, if you take a look at my channel, I do these videos quite regularly. If you'd like to see what I picked up from Kmart this time around, then just keep on watching. So the first few things that I'm gonna share with you are from the office section. And the first thing that I decided to pick up is just this plain black mouse pad. So I recently just got my desktop computer back out. I had it switched off and on the floor for so long. So in setting all of that up, I did need to get a new mouse pad. I threw out my old one because it was disgusting. It had fake tan all over it from my wrist. It was really gross. So I decided to go for a plain black one. It fits the vibe of the room perfectly, and it also won't get dirty like my last one did. I think it was only like $4 or $4.50, $5, something like that. It's really soft. I think it's just gonna be the perfect useful mouse pad. About as useful as a mouse pad can get, I guess. The next thing that I decided to pick up is this whiteboard planner. I'm very, very excited about this. I love the size of it because I'm going to dedicate this specifically to one of my many jobs that I have. Keeping on top of everything can become super overwhelming and anxiety driven. So I thought that I would pick this up and I would use it specifically for one of the jobs to plan my week out and set more of a structured schedule. And if it ends up working out really well for the one job, I'll go ahead and buy two or three more of these so that I can have one specifically dedicated to each job that I have. I'll let you guys know how I end up getting on with this and whether I actually find it useful and I enjoy it. But yeah, I just thought that was really cool, especially because they are so small. If I did decide to go ahead and purchase two or three more, I could quite easily sit them next to each other on my desk or along one of the walls in this room. So the next thing that I picked up from the office section is this file binder thing. Expanding file is what it's called. For those of you that don't know, I do have my own art business and I sell digitalized prints. If you want to check out my artwork, I always have it linked in the description box of all of my videos. But at the moment with all of my prints, I have them in plastic stackable drawers. And I just know the more types of prints that I add to my store, the more of these bulky plastic containers that I'm gonna have to get. And I don't particularly love the idea of having my entire office full of plastic container drawers. I just find that they're super bulky and large, whereas something like this, I can fit the exact same amount of prints in here, but it's nice and compact. So this has quite a few different sections and it expands to be pretty large, which I love. And what I'm planning on doing is just storing all of my prints in these and labeling each section with the print's name so that when someone orders, I can just open this up, flick through to the one that they ordered, pull one out, and then package it. I think that this type of storage idea is going to be a lot more practical and a lot more beneficial in the small space that I do have. So next I have a roll of contact paper, which is something that I have not bought since I was in primary school, grade 5 or 6, covering my books with metallic contact paper. But I actually saw someone else on TikTok or Instagram do this, and it's where they used this contact paper as a backdrop for flat lays. So I don't know, I just just thought that I could use this for product photos when companies want to work with me on Instagram or TikTok. I could use something like this to add a nice, clean and simple background. And there's pictures on here of people using it to cover furniture or desks in their home. Moving on, I'm going to talk about kind of two products at once. Now that Sydney is in lockdown, I feel like Newcastle, where I live, is going to go into lockdown soon. I'm just preparing myself for the long haul, you know? I'm trying to get back into the headspace that I was last lockdown and trying to slowly incorporate things back into my routine that kept me sane back then. And one of those things is having a nightly routine and actually doing some sort of self-care. So I did go ahead and pick up this metallic look peel-off face mask in a coffee scent. Would you say scent or flavor? Scent. We're gonna go with scent. This really intrigued me because it said metallic and I think that it could look really cool when I've got it on my face. That's literally the only reason why I decided to go with this one. But doing stuff like this is something that I really, really enjoyed during lockdown last year. So I thought that I'd pick it up. And at the same time, I also decided to pick up this Hydro Bomb Eye Sheet Mask by Garnier. This particular one says that it's a vegan formula, which we love. And eye masks are honestly one of my favorite self-care things to do in terms of skincare because they're just so easy. You just chuck them on. You don't have to worry about an entire face mask and touching it or rubbing it off. So little eye masks like this are something that I not only feel are a good way to relax for me, but they're also super beneficial. I also decided to pick up a new beauty blender. If you watched my last makeup tutorial, which if you haven't, I recommend. But if you have watched my last makeup tutorial already, you'll know the absolute state of my current beauty blender. It's one that I shared with you probably in my first Kmart haul ever. She's been cut in half to preserve her. And she's no longer white and pink. She's a very dirty, dirty shade of brown. So long story short, I needed an upgrade in my beauty blender. So I decided to pick this one up. I always just pick up the first one that I see. All of the Kmart beauty blender sponges are amazing. I think they work really, really well. And I will never ever purchase another brand, because these are like $3 and they do literally exactly the same thing. Another little random thing that I just quickly threw in my basket is a black pair of tweezers. Absolutely love the vibe of these. I have about 3 or 4 pairs of silver tweezers and they work perfectly fine. Absolutely nothing wrong with them at all, other than the fact that they're not matte black, which these ones are. This right here is a perfect example of a typical Kmart purchase. Something that you just don't need at all, but something that you saw and you were like, yes. I didn't know I needed a pair of black tweezers in my life, but now I know that I do and I love them. Moving into kitchen products and useful things for my kitchen, I did go ahead and pick up another bamboo lid glass container. I featured some of these in maybe not my last Kmart haul, but the one before that. I picked up one of each size and I said that I would let you guys know which one I found to be the most useful. And the answer would be the bigger version, which is the one that I've got here. This is 800 milliliters. It's something that I didn't really realize until I actually started using these, is the fact that the lid actually dips into the actual container. So as you can see from the edge of it there, this whole part here is actually inside of the container. So that takes away space where food could be, if that makes sense. I constantly had the issue of filling these containers up to the top and then going to put the lid on and the lid not fitting, because you need to allow for that excess space that the lid takes up. I would definitely recommend sizing up a size, just because when you do take away the extra space that the lid sits inside, it's really not that big at all. But other than that, I absolutely love these. So I did go ahead and pick up another one of the big size because I love them. I literally use them all the time. I just wanted to make sure that you guys knew about that little thing, because if I had known that previously, I probably wouldn't have gotten the small one that I did in my last video. Next, I have an oven mitt. An oven mitt is just something that I've never ever owned. I've honestly just been using a hand towel as my oven mitt and something to wipe my hands on when I am cooking things in the kitchen. But I have always wanted to pick one of these up. I just normally walk past them at Kmart and I'm like, I do really need one of those, but it's not super necessary, but I do want one, but I don't. So this is a really nice black and white striped material. I love these ones in particular because they do have the little hand pockets so you can like grab stuff out of the microwave and oven. Yay. I don't know. I just think that this is going to be a lot more practical than the bathroom hand towel that I've been using in my kitchen. The second last thing that I have here to share with you is this 3-tier shelf, which I thought could be super useful for the cupboard that I have above my sink. I keep a lot of herbs and spices as well as extra biscuits and long life milk. I have a lot of sauce containers in there. It's just a really random cupboard. And when I saw this making eye contact with me at Kmart, I was like, you're perfect. You're absolutely perfect. I think it will make it a lot easier for me to see things that are at the back of the cupboard because each level is elevated. It also has this grippy material on each level so that things don't slip and slide off. And no matter what you put on here, it's gonna stay in place. So I love this. I honestly do. And I can't wait to organize my cupboards. Adult things. And the very last thing that I have to share with you is this book called The Power of Now, A Guide to Spiritual Enlightenment. So if you know me, you know that I don't typically tend to get books like this. I normally only read poetry books and nothing else. But as of late, I've been trying to work on myself, not only for myself, but also for the people around me as well. So I thought getting into reading some self-help books would be a good idea. So I thought that I would try this one out. I did have a little flick through it while I was at Kmart and it seemed to be okay from the little bits and pieces that I read in store. I obviously haven't read it yet, but I think it's about trying to realign yourself with the present moment and trying to train your brain to not stress out about the future or the past. I think that's a whole lot of what I need in my life right now. I think it also looks really cute and it's gonna look amazing with all of my poetry books. I love it. I'm very excited. That is everything that I have picked up from Kmart over the past couple of weeks. I need to slow it down, I know. But you guys love these videos so much and I love shopping at Kmart. So I'm just like, is there really a problem here? I'm not seeing one at all. So if you did enjoy this video and you would like to see more Kmart hauls, then please don't forget to hit the thumbs up button, subscribe to my channel right down below if you haven't already. And with all of that being said, I love you all so much and I will see you all very, very soon. Goodbye.